Your questions about COVID-19 is Dr. Robert Murphy, professor of infectious diseases at Northwestern University Feinberg School of Medicine. Good morning, doctor. Thank you for joining us this morning.
Good morning.
We had a story about these plasma antibody tests, and I'm wondering if that will lead to getting a vaccine sooner than the year and a half.
I don't think it really has too much to do with getting a vaccine.
Okay.
What it does is it's going to tell us who's been infected with this virus, with COVID-19. That's the biggest thing it's going to do.
And also, in the meantime, people want to know about any of these medications that maybe, is this going to speed up people being able to get out of their house and get back to normal if there's some medication to treat it?
Well, there's nothing to treat it right now. A lot of people are using the chloroquine, hydroxychloroquine, the malaria drugs, directly for the virus. We don't even know if that works, but something is likely to come along. The over-the-counter stuff you can take, you know, that might help some of your symptoms, but right now we're recommending that you stay away from ibuprofen, or the non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs that are in many of the cold remedies that you see in the pharmacy. Just ask the pharmacist, they'll tell you.
All right, let's get to viewer questions. Here's the first one. Given the stats regarding COVID-19 deaths, can you provide some insights about the mortality rate by age group?
Yeah, that's a good question, and it's a somewhat of a moving target as we get more of our local data. But there's no surprises here. The older you are, and if you have underlying diseases like cardiovascular disease, lung disease, or diabetes in particular, you have a higher chance of dying. But that doesn't mean you don't die if you're a young person. We have deaths down into actually a teenager died, a baby died, a very rare occurrence. But we have, the hospital is full of people of every age. They're in the ICU. They're on ventilators, very, very sick. As you see from the report you just had earlier this morning, the police officer was in his 50s, I believe. This is something that can kill anybody. If you're older, it's more likely that you do not survive the infection. But even then, 70% survive.
And there's no way to tell if you're going to get that severe case of this yet, correct?
That's a great question. I wish I could answer that. I can't answer it. We don't understand why some people get such a severe case and why some people are essentially asymptomatic.
Right.
Any age group.
Mm. All right, here's another question. I think you kind of touched on this. If you do get coronavirus, what medication can you take for any cold or flu symptoms besides Tylenol? I know people have been asking about Advil and there was some, ibuprofen. Is that okay to take?
No, there's some controversy there about the ibuprofen, as I mentioned earlier. So I think at this particular point, we should avoid that if at all possible.
All right. And next question, is it wise to get your hair cut? I have a stylist who cuts hair in her home. However, I have lupus, Crohn's, and borderline diabetes. Should I go for haircuts? That seems obvious.
Well, if we don't get out of this isolation, I think we're all going to have the same problem. But if you have to get your hair cut, that's your own personal decision. The operator, the person cutting your hair, probably should be wearing a mask.
All right.
If you can wear a mask during a haircut, you should wear a mask too to protect them.
All right. Here's another one. Is vacation planned for July in California safe? What about a cruise in September? People are asking, should I summer vacation toward the end of summer? Is it going to be okay?
I've been asked this question quite a bit because planning vacations, of course, is time, is money. This is a very common question. I was quoted recently as saying fall is the new summer. I think planning anything for this summer is very, very risky. I wouldn't put any money down that you couldn't get back on anything this summer.
Mm.
As far as cruise ships go, forget it for now. This whole thing has to be really completely gone before you get back on a cruise ship.
All right, Dr. Murphy, we appreciate you joining us again. You can go to our Morning News Facebook page and post your questions for Dr. Murphy there. We'll talk to him again on Monday.
Thank you too very much. For the great reporting.
Well, thank you. And thanks for appearing with us every day. And you have a good weekend.
You too.
All right.
Take care.
Thanks, doctor. Hey, Paul.